Deidre Melton, Yvonne Marsh, how you doing? Gilda Bermudez, Nia Cruz, somebody tell me who's singing this. Willie Christmas Smith, what's going on, brother? Desiree Chisholm, Constance Scales, Robin Cornegay, Valerie Madden, how are you? Gilda Bermudez, Teresa Boyd Hardy, Beatrice Longwell, how are you? Good evening, Renee Holman, how are you? L. Malik Williams, Michelle Lang, Northy Corona, praise the Lord. Charlie Casanova, yes, son. Tell me who's singing. Alice Thomas, hold it down. Cheryl Pace, how are you? Jennifer Ruiz, how are you? Good evening, Terry Hurd. Connie McQueen, good afternoon. Salima Imani Bay, good afternoon to you. Amy Thompson, Donald Lee. Eileen Rivera, Kimberly Jones, Chancy Armstrong, how are you? Madeline Waterbay Del Rios, good evening, stay blessed. Kathy Paschel, thank you, appreciate you. God bless you, Bertha Moore. I know I was looking for the whispers, Bertha. I couldn't find the song. Please tell me the song. I was sitting here, that's why I'm late. Looking for that song you told me to play. Craig Jones. The night owl. How are you? I had to play the OJ's, man. I had to play the OJ's because I couldn't find the song Bertha told me to play. Supreme Elevation. Peace. Hold the line, brother. I'll need some Baytox. Minutee. Elizabeth Rainey, how are you? Good evening, Shavonda McClain. Mary Flanoy, bless you. Good evening, Angela Du Bois. How are you? Tania Goldsmith, Sandy Subs, Maurice, you man senior, peace. Gene Hill, how are you? Shanita, Karen Davis, good evening. Minutee Shane and Chocolate. Sharonda Bailey, got to get the beef out. That's the 70s, grew up on this. Thelma Riggins. Janice Lucas, no house music festival this weekend, y'all, unfortunately. Joyce Hargrove, I look forward to that every year, too. Nicole Harbin, that's right, Momo Senso, the OJs. There you go. I was looking for you, Momo, I ain't seen you in days. Sister Top White, how are you? D. Brown. What is this, Danny Hero? I got to look at that and see what that is. Oh, good, good. It had a yellow sticker. Yolanda Hassan Collins, good evening. Manny Evans, good. Johnny Cannon, good evening. Good evening. The Shabazz pull-up graduation was crazy. Shout out to Mr. Gifted, principal at Shabazz. That was outrageous. Good job. Bridget Butler, Takiya T.T. Robinson, Rose Mosley, good evening. Timothy May, Robin White, Margaret Jackson, Danielle Walker, got to give the people what they want. Y'all can't miss, that's the OJs. I'm waiting for that whisper song as I was trying to play it. You know what I mean? I need to break things up a little bit. The monotony plays a different kind of song. I was looking for that, couldn't find it. So give me the title again before you get off of that. Please give me the title. Give me the title of that song. Oh, okay. Momo, you got to be on here. I like to say Momo says so. You mess my day up if I don't get to do that. Got to find a way to get on. We're going to call Facebook and get on them if you're not on here now. So I'm going to give out the numbers, and then I'm going to talk a little bit about our new strategy for testing and what you should be doing. Then I have a couple other announcements that I want to make. 7,617 positive cases here. In the city of Newark, that's 25 more cases than yesterday, and no deaths in the city, no deaths at all. Thank God for that. 18,377 cases in the county, 1,740 two deaths, which is different than they had reported yesterday. So what happens is, and I'm going to just give you clarity on some of these numbers. Sometimes when people get tested in Newark or they go to the hospital in Newark, we count them as Newark residents. So we count them in our numbers. We find out that they, in fact, are not Newark residents or they are somewhere else, then they have to be counted in the city that they're from. So that makes our numbers go down or change. Even in the zip code, if they come in and we think they're from that zip code, we add it there, and then we take it off and we find out they're, in fact, not from the area. So the county reported yesterday a little higher, then those numbers went down. New Jersey, 167,120 positive cases with 12,670 deaths. East Orange had 1,910 cases with 207 deaths. Irvington, 1,380 cases with 146 deaths. Orange, 991 cases with 82 deaths. Just want to shout everybody out in those cities doing a great job holding the line, making sure those cases are not rising above. We are hovering anywhere between 8 to 10% now, y'all. We have to make sure we stay at 10% or below. Are we gonna go back to where we came from? There are people outside, they're eating, they're having a good time, they're hanging out at those stores all on Ferry Street and everywhere else. If those people are not wearing masks inside serving you, if there's too many people gathered up together, we're going to shut those stores down, and you may have a good time for 2 or 3 days, but it's going to cost us another month, and you don't want to be out for another month just for one night of fun. Pace yourself. Do it correctly. Be safe. Make sure you are doing the right thing so you can stay open, have some staying power. That way we can stay open and move towards you going inside. There are places that are already putting people inside. You're not supposed to be eating inside anywhere. That hasn't even been approved by the state, never mind the city. No one should be eating inside anywhere. If they're letting you inside, they're doing the wrong thing. They're putting you in jeopardy. I know you're tempted to do it. There's an old Twilight Zone called A Man in the Cave. They just had like a big, giant nuclear explosion, and the man in the cave they couldn't see was telling them what to eat and what not to eat, and they were stressing because they were so hungry. They wanted to drink. They wanted to party. And this cat came from out of town. He convinced them to the heck with the man in the cave, to eat and drink, and they all died, right? We're going to have to be disciplined, right? Pace ourselves. Do what's right. It's better for us to have longevity than two nights of fun. You know, these guys want to go there, and they let you in their store because they're desperate. Now, I understand the desperation. They lost money over 3 months. It's a serious desperation. And then if you're going to go for it, some of them may let you do it. But, you know, I want you to be of right mind and protect your family and do what's necessary to keep your family safe and keep yourself safe. And don't go to these places that are overcrowded. If they don't have a sticker on the window or the door, don't go inside. And if people are serving you without masks, they could be inside coughing and sneezing on your food. You don't know that. They're bringing you your drinks with fresh cough in it, right? With fresh talking residue in it. They must have on a mask. You must make them wear a mask. You're eating there. They're coming out. Tell them to put on a mask. As a matter of fact, it's mandatory for them to have on a mask. So if they don't have on a mask, you have a right to say, where is your mask? So you have to do it. I mean, that's the best thing for you. I know zip code information wasn't that correct because of the numbers are going up and down because of what I told you earlier. I got a couple of emails I didn't read. I'm going to read them tomorrow and respond to them in the morning. Thank you for the emails. Thank you, Lynn. I know you on it, who are watching the zip code numbers and making sure they come out correctly. If you see any discrepancies, let me know. We found some, and I'm going to say those discrepancies today. And those come from us finding out people, in fact, do not live in that area and removing them from your zip code. So 07102 has 273 positive cases now. 07103 has 901. On the 15th, we counted it as 902. One of those people were removed from you. 07104 has 1599, right? On the 15th, you had 1603. There were people who were moved. We moved people from that zip code who did not, in fact, live in that zip code. 07105 has 1242. On the 15th, it was 1250. People are being moved from the zip code. 07106, 813. So some of you might get larger numbers because they're being attributed to the right zip code. 07107, 1297. Or outside of the city. 07108 has 597. On the 15th, it was 599. 07112 has 598. On the 15th, it was 601. Please correct those numbers. If you're following us and taking the numbers, correct those numbers. 07114 has 319 deaths by zip code. 07102, 31. 07103, 109. 07104, 133. 07105, 48. 07106, 70. On the 15th, it was reported 71. 07107, 77. 07108, 67. On the 15th, it was reported 68. 07112, 52. 07114, 23. 07114, 23. Those are the numbers, right? And we have zero deaths. We have zero deaths. Zero deaths. So please, if you're keeping track of the numbers, keep us correct. Email me if you see discrepancies. I'm going to respond to some of that tomorrow, but I explained some of it today. If we find out, in fact, they don't live in that zip code, we're going to take them off. We find out when we get the information, because some people put the wrong information down initially, unfortunately. We find out they're not city residents. We're going to put them in a city where they live at, and we're going to reduce our numbers. Unfortunately, when people come in, they don't give their nationality, and sometimes they give us false information or wrong information. I should say, we find out the right information, we have to, in fact, correct it, because we are keeping track of our numbers here in Newark very methodically, very thoughtfully, so we can really find out if we are driving the numbers down. It's important for us to do that because we are opening up now. So the testing sites, we're probably going to have maybe four or five permanent testing sites. We're moving all around now. Today, we were testing in Hyatt Court. We were in Hyatt Court testing, so we bring in the test to people. People are saying, why didn't bring it down here earlier? Because we had the testing site four or five blocks away from you at the Kenneth Gibson Aquatic Center, and you didn't come. So now we have to uproot it and bring it to you, and that's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be bringing testing sites to South Orange Avenue, to Ferry Street, to all these places where people are out hanging out, eating. We're going to bring it right to your neighborhood, test people on the spot. Why? Because we need to see if there's spikes, if people are getting infected as they go out, as we open up. We need to find out if we are in danger. And if we are in danger, we're going to back up. And we're going to have people fill out questionnaires about symptoms. And if you have symptoms, go get tested. If you have symptoms, go get tested. If you're asymptomatic, right? If you got tested, you tested positive, you were asymptomatic. Stay in the house for 14 days like they tell you to do, quarantine yourself. Then after that, you should do symptom checks periodically. Do symptom checks periodically, right, to make sure you, in fact, are not getting sick. And you should stay in for the 14 days because just because you don't have any symptoms the first time you get tested, you need to make sure that they don't come out during that 14-day period. Stay in the house. And if you do have symptoms, you have to wait a period of time. You have to wait 3 days where you do not have symptoms at all, where you do not have to take medicine, and you do not feel sick at all before you even begin to venture out. 3 straight days with no symptoms, no medication, no nothing. That's what you need in order to feel like you are at least in the clear if you have symptoms. And we want more people to take the test. If you haven't taken the test yet, particularly for people who've never taken the test, we need you to take the test. We now are encouraging the folks to use the short swabs. I know they're using the long nose swabs. There's short swabs that they use now. They don't have to stick all the way up your nose. We're getting ready to encourage our vendors to use those so it's less intrusive, less invasive for you, and invasive, so that you could get out of there without pain. We want you to get out of there without pain, please. That's important, and we need people to get tested. So the mask is the new normal. New normal is mask. Wear your mask. Wash your hands like a crazy person. Wash. In my pocket. This is what I got. This is what I have in my pocket all day. Hand sanitizer in my pocket all day long. This is what I keep with me. If I don't have on gloves, I wash my hands. Even if I have on gloves, when I take them off, I clean my hands again. Do it like a madman. Keep washing your hands. You don't know what you touched by accident, who touched you by accident, whatever. Wash your hands over and over again. Wear a mask. Keep distance 6 feet apart. Try to avoid touching your face as much as you possibly can. If you've never been tested, get tested and pay attention to your symptoms. Pay attention to your symptoms, but you must have a mask. I went up and down Ferry Street. I've seen so many people without masks. They're eating out. They're having a great time. No mask. Obviously, you can't eat with a mask, and they don't expect you to eat while you have on your mask. But if you're not eating and you're talking, you should be wearing it. The people serving you should be wearing it, right? Many, many stores were not doing that. I'm telling you, tonight they're going to be warning people. Tomorrow they're going to be warning people. The next day they're going to be closing your store. Just a warning. That's what's going to happen. It's only the right thing to do. They're going to, and it is simple to follow instructions. Follow instructions. And all of you people who have beauty parlors, barbershops, nail salons, we're going to get to you. I know that a lot of inspections haven't been coming out. We're going to get to you. Trust me, we're going to get to you. We got to get to you soon. At the end of this week, beginning of next week, we're going to do all those spots to check you. I know you are anxious. We're coming to make sure you're able to open in a safe way. And you guys are even more critical than the restaurants to follow instructions. Do what you're supposed to do. Please, we don't want to close you down. You were already closed for 3 months. I know how difficult and desperate the situation is. Please do the right thing so we do not have to close your store down. Follow instructions, right? Please, follow instructions. Follow instructions. Phase 3 is June 29th to July 12th. That's phase 3, June 29th. That's when nail salons get open. June 29th, nail salons. June 29th, barbershops and hair salons are the 22nd. The 22nd to 22nd. The 29th are nail salons. 29th are nail salons. Also, the 22nd is limited fitness, limited gym, limited fitness, limited gym. I'm telling you, we're going to come to those places and see a pack of people in there. You're going to get thrown out. We're going to close the store. If you don't have any signs on there that say you've been inspected by the city, we're going to close you down. Don't go into the store that is not inspected. Do not go into the store that is not inspected. Please don't go into any stores that's not inspected. Please. Jackie Fussell, I'm going to answer a couple of questions before I go down here. I'm going to make a habit to do that. So the saliva test, we're still doing a saliva test. The CDC is saying that the saliva test is not as accurate as the nasal swab. The saliva test is not as accurate as the nasal swab. And there is a nasal swab that does not have to go all the way in your nose. There's a shorter one, right? There's a shorter one. So you can use that, please. And when you go to those places, tell them, you know, you want the shorter swab, that you want the shorter swab. It is less. Listen, I had the long one done. It hurts, right? It hurts. So, but it's necessary. It's still necessary. It's still necessary. When people are not practicing social distancing, so no one should be out in the street past 10 p.m., right? If they're in their house, like in their backyard, there's nothing really you can do. That's their property. There is still a noise ordinance. They shouldn't be blasting the music all hours of the night. And the barbecue supposed to have no more than 15 people, given the size. If it's the small backyard, big backyard, even if they're on their porch or on their own property, that's fine. Nothing in the street, nothing going on like that. They can't have those kind of things. Those are not allowed. As a matter of fact, it says indoor dining is not allowed. Now, I'm going to answer this question. Indoor dining is not allowed yet. When it is allowed, it'll be 25% CD capacity. That's phase 3. That's not until the 29th. Phase 3 until the 29th is indoor dining is the 29th. Phase 3, it is 25% of the capacity that you have. And that's June 29th. June 29th is indoor dining. Anybody that's feeding you indoors before June 29th is breaking the law. Yep, it's breaking the law. You have to wear those masks, please. Also, if you're a business owner, you have to go to NURIC COVID-19 and fill out that application. Fill out the application. NURIC COVID-19 and fill out your application, please. If you don't have an application, you can't get an inspection. If you don't have an inspection, you can't open up. You can't open up. You can't open up. You can't open up. Sandra Williams, you said you tested twice. That's an anomaly, and you haven't gotten any results from two tests. I've been tested three times. Got the results, and I got tested at Weekway Park. I got tested at the FQAC folks tested me. Sunrise tested me as well. So I got my results. You should call. I would call the number that where you got tested at and ask them for the results if that's the case. Sounds strange. To me. Should your kids be tested? Well, if the kids haven't been exposed to anyone, I would check their symptoms. If I have little children, I would be cautious of getting them tested, like babies. I'm talking about under 3 years old. The only person they are susceptible to is you. If you feel like you are in fact in jeopardy and their children are around you, yes, I would do what I can to get them tested or check their symptoms. Yep, the firecrackers are killing me too, y'all. Holy smoke. Firecrackers are killing me on my block. Firecrackers, M80s, everything. The police respond to what they can, but they're running all over the city responding to firecrackers. And this time of year, responding to firecrackers, M80s, and all kind of fireworks throughout the city. It's not legal for people to pop off firecrackers without supervision. So the police come and try to end it. I know some of them, they have ended, but it is difficult because they're popping them off all over the city. Right. We are down on Ferry Street right now. Somebody asked me a question about Ferry Street. We're down there right now, and our folks are down there right now. And in fact, making sure that they are doing what they're supposed to do. We're going to stay down there till about 9 o'clock. We're going to monitor that for today and tomorrow. We're going to make sure that people are doing what they're supposed to do. We don't want them to close. We want them to be open. We want them to make money. We want people to eat out of there, but we want it also to be safe. We want it to be safe. We want it to be safe. 100%. 100%. We need it to be safe. So if you don't think it's safe, then let me know, please. We will get there and get down there, please. So I'm going to read some of this stuff because some of y'all got the same questions. Street sweeping has resumed. You should receive a robocall today to remind you of alternate side parking as we resume street sweeping. This means that cars in violation of the alternate side parking ordinance will be ticketed or towed. You have to move your car during street sweeping. We gave you a break for a bunch of months. Now the streets are filthy. We have to clean up, y'all. We started cleaning up Saturday. We are resuming street sweeping. So you have to move your car and follow the street sweeping things. Tonight, remember, I'll be on Facebook Live talking about at 7 p.m. Talking about the making of the first black mayor, Ken Gibson. This will be a great discussion with Jesse Jackson. Will be on there today. And remember to fill out your census, 2020census.gov, 2020census.gov, or call 844-330-2020. And just got a reminder from Hope Little. Please do not leave your gloves and mask everywhere on the street. Pick your gloves up. Pick your mask up. In fact, don't put them down. When you finish with your gloves and mask, throw them in the garbage. There is room for cross-contamination. Please don't do that. Follow, and Hope is absolutely correct. Do not throw your garbage on the floor. You shouldn't throw any garbage on the floor in the city of Newark, by the way, but definitely not those masks and gloves. Yep. Somebody asked about the color code signs. Listen, we are passing those signs out now. Obviously, if a store is open and they don't have the color code sign, these are non-essential stores, not the essential ones. The non-essential stores, if they don't have a color-coded sign, you report them. We're going to close them. We're going to close them. We're going to close them down. We're going to close them. The four-wheeler bikes. Now, listen. They get on my nerves just as much as you, and they come by my block, not on it, but by it. The police have orders not to chase those guys. They know it. Because it gets dangerous, we chase them on a bike, somebody can get hurt, and we obviously don't want nobody to hurt or hurt themselves badly over something that is not, it's just an inconvenience and a nuisance, not really a, a kind of violent, a kind of crime. So we try to catch them before they get on it, or catch them when they get off of it, and confiscate the bikes. That's what we try to do. We don't want to chase them because they can get out of control really quickly, go on a sidewalk, run into a tree, run into anything, a car. So we have orders not to chase them. We just follow them. And when they get off, we try to do what we can about that. So you're saying nobody in the North Ward is wearing their mask. We're going over there. I'm going to tell them that you said so. Let me get your name. You went up too fast. We're going to get up there. We're going to get those names. And we're going to make sure we get those stores and everybody else to wear those masks, please. I just want to shout out my friend, Dr. Albert Lewis. Today is his birthday, Reverend Dr. Albert Lewis. This is the hat that he gave me that I keep handy. Victory, 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 victory. Happy birthday, Dr. Albert Lewis. Many, many, many more to you. He just turned 20 probably. God bless you, man. Keep up the great work that you are doing for our city and all of us. Bulk trash pickup July 1st. I've been saying it over and over and over again, Denise. Bulk trash July 1st. Plus, when we do the community cleanups, we're putting the big green cans out all over the neighborhoods so you can put your stuff in then. We did it in the South Ward. We'll be in the West Ward this Saturday. I'll give you all of the places where we're going to be at in the West Ward. Hopefully by tomorrow, I'll have that information for you. We're doing the East Ward after that, the Central Ward after that, and the North Ward after that, so that you'll know where the green can's in. But overall, bulk pickup begins again July 1. Bulk pickup. Unemployment is a mess. It's a mess. I mean, we're doing what we can. I would call our office at Newark Works, speak to Rahman Muhammad or somebody that works down there to see if they can help you figure out this unemployment thing with the state. And we'll figure it out for you. If anybody from the city is watching, that's going to be on our call. I just got information that Margaritas on Central Avenue is open with no color-coded sign. Margaritas on Central Avenue. Hopefully somebody from there is open so they can get it right before we go up there and shut them down. Please. And if you want to do it like that, folks, if you want to tell me on this call stores that are like that, I will definitely, definitely, definitely give them a shout out. Please. Please. Yep. Thank you. I appreciate y'all today. God bless you. I see you guys tomorrow.